The Utah Department of Transportation is currently considering building what would be the world's longest gondola system to help ease traffic issues in Little Cottonwood Canyon. The 8.3-mile public transit system would take riders from the Lakai restaurant in Sandy to Snowbird Ski Resort in about 27 minutes, and on to the town of Alta in about 37 minutes. The system would reach heights of 230 feet above the ground as it travels up the canyon. The final Alta station is about 3,500 feet higher in elevation than the lower Lakai station. Two turning stations are planned. These allow the gondolas to change direction as they navigate the canyon terrain. One of the turning stations would be about a quarter of the way up the canyon, and the other about three quarters of the way up near the Tanner's Flat campground. Passengers would not be able to load or disembark at these stations in the current proposal, but that could be changed in the future. The current road up the canyon is only two lanes wide for most of its length. This means that any vehicle breakdowns or rock slides during the busy ski season can bring traffic to a standstill. The road is also frequently closed due to avalanches. The gondola system would allow people and emergency responders to travel up and down the canyon even when the road is closed. The gondola project would cost around $592 million. The other alternative UDOT is considering costs around $510 million and consists of widening the road up the canyon and adding new buses and bus lanes. Widening the road would only be possible on the north side of the canyon since the creek lies on the south side of the road. Road widening would require the removal of a large number of trees, boulders, and dirt, which could decrease the stability of the hillside next to the road. The gondola system would cause less disruption to the natural contour of the canyon. The proposed system would be a Doppelmayr 3S system. Each individual car would seat 32 passengers, and the entire system would move a little over 1,000 passengers up and down the canyon per hour. The system could include amenities such as heated seats, phone chargers, and Wi-Fi connections. Opposition to the gondola system seems to be mostly centered around the increased traffic below the canyon due to the parking structure at the Lakai station. UDOT has suggested that light rail could eventually be run to the Lakai station to further ease traffic.
So I feel like paving all this pavement over the roads for maybe, 10, 15 days that the canyon's closed is unnecessary for us neighbors trying to get out. So I feel like it's excessive.
UDOT recently held a public forum to gauge support for the proposed system.
So we started with the five alternatives, right? We had two bus alternatives, two gondola alternatives, and a cograil alternative. And we narrowed that down to two for the draft EIS. And I think it's important to note that at the final EIS, we will narrow that down to a single preferred alternative. So this isn't a both situation. We will narrow it down to one alternative.
Ultimately, in my opinion, the fastest way to solve this problem is to incentivize people to get on the bus first.
UDOT should reconsider its two alternatives and wait to do anything other than express bus service without additional road building, just as Mayor Wilson commented today. It should also be done without additional parking garages, as those will induce demand and are wasteful when we already have numerous locations already available throughout the valley to be repurposed. The two proposed alternatives literally do the opposite of what we need by pointing more vehicles to the mouth of the canyon. Dave Field mentions getting cars out of the canyon, which I agree with, but it is not fair to push that traffic into our foothill neighborhoods.
Now, looking to the future, the passion of everyone in this room is absolutely understandable. But the reality is the demand for use is not going to go down, and the demand is already there. The state's population is a lot higher than it used to be, and it is growing. The country's population is a lot higher than it used to be, and we get more visitors to this state than we used to get. I think it's going to be difficult to attempt to turn the clock back through regulatory force. The question is how we handle the future reality wisely and prudently, and it's a question of finding the best trade-off, because there is no ideal and no perfect solution. I believe that if we shoot for reducing the number of vehicles in the canyon total, that that points to a gondola system. The buses have a negative impact on air, water, and noise, even aside from all the engineering problems of trying to widen the road. And any attempt to increase buses without some sort of shoulder is absolutely unrealistic in my view. The gondola actually has the lowest environmental impact. It may improve the water quality. It will certainly improve the noise quality and reduce emissions within the canyon, and it's the only way that will ultimately allow limiting traffic in the future. We need to learn the lesson from Switzerland. There are people ahead of us who are years ahead of us who have figured out the best trade-offs to resolve these problems. Travel to Zermatt, below the Matterhorn, and see what they've done. And I assure you from personal experience that they have not destroyed the natural beauty of that place. I would suggest that if a gondola is adopted, that they would consider a stop at Tanner's Flat. I'm running out of time. The resort operators obviously should pay part, and how it should be organized to attempt to make it into a profit-making venture, of course, requires a lot of detailed work, but thank you.
The Utah Department of Transportation is currently taking comments on the proposal and plans to make final determination on whether to build the gondola system or widen the road in winter of 2022. Comments can be submitted via the link in the description. Thanks for watching. Bye.